वेलकम बैक टू द टर्म 3 ऑनलाइन क्लास क्लास 6 सब्जेक्ट साइंस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ यूनिट 2 वाटर। फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ वाटर। वाटर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ह्यूमन बीइंग्स, प्लांट्स, एनिमल्स एंड ऑल द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स इन द अर्थ। ह्यूमन बॉडी uses water in all its cells, organs and tissues to help regulate its temperature and maintain other body functions. On an average, the human body requires 2 to 3 liters of water per day for proper functioning. Water helps in digestion of food and removal of toxins, that is waste products from our body. So, our human body needs water for its main function. Apart from drinking, people use water for many other purposes. These include cooking, bathing, washing, washing clothes, washing utensils, keeping houses and common places clean, and watering the plants, etc. So, these purposes are known as domestic purposes. So, apart from drinking, we need water for our domestic purposes also. Food gives main energy for all the living organisms. So, water is also essential for the healthy growth of farm crops and farm stock and is used in the manufacture of many products. So, water is very important in agriculture field also and in industries. Industries depends on water at all levels of production. It is used as a material, a solvent, and for generating electricity also we need water. So, water is very important for drinking purposes, for living, and for domestic purposes, agriculture purposes, and also for industry and making electricity also, we need water. So, water is very, very important in our day-to-day life. Next, we are going to see about the water distribution and treatment system. We know that water is very important for us, isn't it? So, we know water is distributed by the local bodies. We are not in the villages, they can get the water readily from the lakes, ponds or wells or bore wells. But in town areas, we can get the water by the local bodies. So, in some areas which water is obtained from river, lake and groundwater is treated and distributed. Not as it is distributed, it is treated and distributed. So, in this picture, we can see about the model of the distribution and treatment system. First, the river or lake water is taken and with the help of the pump, it is collected in a tank and it undergoes some chemical treatment and the sludge and all, it is taken away from that water and then it is treated with one more tank which contains the coal, sand and gravel. So, in that the water get filtered and then it is disinfected with the chlorine and ammonia. So, we can get the clear water after disinfectant. Then it can be pumped and it is taken to the overhead tanks. So, from the overhead tanks, the water is distributed to the villages and all the houses individually, or from the tank itself, they can distribute it to one common pipe. So, this is the water distribution and treatment system which is followed in our government. Let me do one activity. When you happen to see any leaking tap in your school or home, keep a bucket to collect the water that is leaking. Measure the amount of water and the time taken to fill the bucket. After noting the time taken to fill a bucket, you can estimate the amount of water getting wasted on a day. So, can you think over the amount of water getting wasted all around the world from a leaking taps. So you can estimate that from one leaking tap, how much amount of water getting wasted. Like that, all around the world, how much water getting wasted. Already we saw the composition of water that we get readily to drink. So all the water is, the fresh water is in the form of ice caps and glaciers. So we can have only very little amount of water on the surface for drinking purpose and other uses. So domestic uses, agriculture uses, for all other uses we need water. So we should avoid the leakage of water and wastage of water anywhere. So you are to very aware of that. A single drop of water should not be getting wasted. So please aware, and you have to create awareness around your circles, friend circles, or in your home or nearby your people. So anywhere you have to create a awareness of saving water and not a wasting of water. Okay, children. Do you know about swamps, children? Swamps are wetlands that are forested. So wetlands that are forested is called swamps. They occur along large rivers or on the shores of the large lakes. The water of a swamp may be fresh water, brackish water, or sea water. Swamps are important for providing fresh water and oxygen to all life. So some of the examples of swamps in our Tamil Nadu are Pichavaram mangroves, that forest we can call it as mangrove forest. So Pichavaram mangroves in Chidambaram, Muthupet mangrove wetland, Pallikaranai wetland in Chennai, Chembarambakkam in Kanjipuram are few examples of swamps in Tamil Nadu which give the fresh water and fresh oxygen to all the life. So swamps take part a very important role in giving oxygen to all the life. Now are you ready for home fun, children? You have to fill a tabular column, that is estimation of water consumed by a family on a day. So we have given, in left side we have given brushing, bathing, washing clothes, toilets, cooking, washing utensils, cleaning floor, and any other purposes. So you have to write the estimated amount of water for brushing, 1 mug, bathing, 1 bucket. Like that you have to write the estimated amount of water in the tabular column, and then you have to total the amount of water used by a family per day. Okay, so this is the activity. So you can find out how much water we need per day, a family need per day how much water. So like that we can calculate a whole world how much water it needs per day. So we can know about the importance of water and importance of saving water and not wasting the water. Hope you enjoyed this lesson very well, children. So we have to keep save the water for our future use. Okay, children, let we meet in the next session. Thank you.